We're going to recruit and destroy their capacity to recruit. We're going to wade into them, and we're not going to give up.
Yes. No.
And why should we? We're Americans.
And we elected an historic president. And unfortunately, it's historically bad. Because we know we have to begin to restore our country to limited constitutional principles that our founders intended. Loud and clear, November 2nd, count down the hours because we're taking our country back.
Yeah!
All of you, over and over I've heard the newspapers and other people say, oh, he's associated with the Tea Party. And I said, hell yeah, I'm associated with the Tea Party.
And the thing that I've learned the most about from the Tea Party is the need for math education in the United States. Because after that Tea Party, based on the newspaper reports, I'd say there's probably three people here today. So we need to help these people with their math skills.
I retired from the service and I came back to Oregon. That was not the Oregon that I left. So I want to change it in Salem that you have the choice in the state, not the people who are elected down in Salem.
It is time we energize ourselves, we get our butts off of the couch, and we get moving, and we show them this is our country, and you are not taking our freedom.
We can work together to take this country back to becoming the constitutional republic that it is. And I ask you to take a look at that right now because we've got to reform.
I'm tired of the yes men in the Capitol. We need to take our freedom back and we need to do it now. Thank you.
I'm just sick to death of the bureaucrats in Salem taxing, spending, and regulating us to death. And we have to elect leaders who can, who are willing to stand up to the public employee unions. And I can, and I will, and I'm not afraid of a broken kneecap.
I'm running against the Speaker of the House out of Salem. His name is Dave Hunt. And he's strong to arms people into spending more money that we don't have and making decisions that are not wise. So let's remove him and put new people in power.
Think about it. Liberty is not just the right of free speech, the right to vote, the right to be represented by legal counsel when one's accused of a crime, but the right to engage in economic commerce in our day-to-day lives, and at the end of the day, the right to be happy, to be free in our lives, to deal with our families and our friends the way we choose to, not the way government would have us do it.
Exceptionalism is the idea that the United States and the American people hold a special place in the world by offering freedom, opportunity, and hope for humanity. Derived from its unique balance of public and private interests, governed by constitutional ideals that are focused on personal and economic freedom. That's what's under assault. That's what we're here to save. And save it, we will.